Every day, more and more of our end users come to work with a variety of nutritional puzzles to solve. Puzzles that no longer have to be solved using U.S. soybeans. As a result, there are more and more times when animal nutrition experts aren't even thinking in terms of purchasing soybean meal, because they're actually focused on buying a nutrient that helps produce the optimum rate of gain for their animals. So now that soybeans are becoming a go-to source of so many nutrients for so many different buyers, maybe it's finally time to share the soybean industry secret that's less of a secret every day. Over the last few years, our soybean value chain transitioned from being in the bushel business to being in the bundle business, the nutritional bundle. A change that, for the record, isn't good news, it's great news. When our value chain's customers get the nutritional bundle they're looking for from soybeans, then their profitability is enhanced and they grow. And bigger customers mean more orders. But the first step to valuing our soybeans differently is to start talking about them differently, using the one common language that allows us all to achieve our goals. A language called constituent value. And from one end of the value chain to the other, that conversation needs to start now. Maybe such conversation leads us to focus on more than just a protein and oil count, but a nutrient count. Maybe it leads to end users attaching higher values to individual nutrients. Kind of like when you pay a higher price at the pizzeria for your favorite slice. In time, it could even be the idea that enables our chain-wide focus on continuous improvement and transparency to boost soybean compositional quality and volume in ways that drive revenue potential from end to end like never before. From seed companies and soybean farmers, all the way to our end users and beyond. One chain, one language, one future.